Hi, my name is Kevin Slattery, and I'm a student here at the University of Nebraska-Lincoln. And my friends tell me that I'm way addicted to social media. You know, they say I'm always on my phone, always on the computer, and on Twitter and everything. I don't think that I am. You know, I'm on it just as much as everyone else. You know, we're in the day and age that's all we do. Everything is social media, and everyone's on Twitter, and that's how you got to keep up with the time. So I don't think that I'm on it more than anyone else. It's just kind of like, you know, hashtag get off my back, you know? I don't use it as much as everyone does. And, you know, they're trying to have me get help, and they want me to go see some professional help. You know, my girlfriend broke up with me. She said that I neglected her. All I could do was just be on the computer and everything. And she hated how I would talk in hashtags or whatever, but it's just how it's done. So, you know, my friends want me to get help, but I'm not addicted. So I don't see what the point in doing that would be.
Hi, I'm Chris Jones. I'm a student here at the University of Lincoln, Nebraska, and I'm addicted to social media. I would say it started out my freshman year, just when it was the rise of Facebook, but just one second. Okay, all right. Just once Facebook started getting more popular, then Twitter, and then hashtags became the norm, I just lost control. I just don't even know what time of day it is half the time. I just always have to look at my phone for my notifications. I don't even know where my friends are half the time, unless they check in somewhere. This is my story.
Hey, let's go get dinner at Sally.
All right, let's go. I'm hungry. Oh, I better check in on Foursquare first.
Hey, how's your day going?
It was really good, thanks. I talked to Breck, and we were just talking about how we were going to meet up and go downtown this weekend, and what I just said?
Yeah, of course.
Okay, well, so then we were going to go downtown, and then we were probably going to go to this one in bar, and you're not even listening to me.
I'm listening, of course.
You're like the worst boyfriend ever.
Hold on. Oh!
Really, Chris? Really?
So, my girlfriend just walked out on me. She was pretty mad. I'm really not even sure what about. I don't know, my social media addiction is really just starting to take hold of my personal life. I think it's really time that I go get some help.
Hey Chris, what's up? Yeah, I'm at the Union.
Where are you at?
I'm over by, like, you know, by the window and where all the signs, the athletic signs and pictures are.
Yeah, I think I see you. All right.
See you in a little bit.
Bye.
Hey, what's up, Kevin?
Hey, what's up, man? How's it going?
Hey, so Kevin, I really want to talk to you about the social media problem you got going on.
Look, I just played shenanigans for 80 points on Words with Friends. Dude, look at that. All right. John doesn't even know what hit him.
All right, Words with Friends can wait, because by the end of this, you might not even have any more friends, man. Just today, my girlfriend walked out on me, stormed, just mad as hell.
So? What'd you do?
I wasn't even listening to her. She was telling me about her problems.
She never talks about anything interesting anyway. Who cares?
Man, that's not even the point. But just before any more relationships are ruined, we really need to get help for our social media.
What do you mean, we? I don't have a problem.
Man, I see you on Facebook just as often as I'm online.
What am I supposed to do, just ignore notification? I mean, it's not my fault that my friends are blowing me up all the time.
Bro, they're hitting you up because they don't see you anymore.
They see me, I'm around. You see me right now, don't you?
Kevin, this is exactly what I'm talking about. I was talking with a couple of the guys in our crew. No one knows what you do anymore.
Well, maybe they should just check Twitter or Foursquare. How do they not know where I'm at? I let everyone know where I'm at all the time.
That's not even the point.
I'm actually the mayor of the union right now, actually.
And what's that going to do for you?
I'm the mayor. What do you mean, what is that going to do for me?
Kevin, as your best friend, I'm trying to help you out, man.
You're the one with the problem. I don't have a problem. I'm on my phone just the normal amount as any other college student.
No, no. Kevin, you got through 3 batteries in 1 week.
So what?
You're on there way too much.
Because the phone sucks, that's why. I'm not on there too much. I'm on Twitter. I just tweet, you know, everyone tweets. Facebook, get notifications, check it, update my status. It's nothing out of the ordinary. It's not affecting my life at all.
Kevin, Sprint is willing to pay you to stop using their unlimited data. That's how bad it is.
I'm going to switch to Verizon anyways.
Kevin,
Verizon has better data plan.
Kevin, go get some help. Let's just go get some help.
You can go get help. Tell me how it goes. I don't need help.
All right.
This is a good tweet.
Okay, man.
Wants me to go get help. Hashtag weirdo.
Kevin, listen. Today I'm going to go see a therapist today at 5 o'clock.
About the time you went and saw somebody about your problems.
All right, that's the way you feel. That's all right, man.
I just don't know why you think I have a problem. You're the one that lost a girlfriend over your social media.
All right, man. If you change your mind, you know my number. Just hit me up, all right?
All right. I suppose I could. But I need to. All right. See you, man. Oh, I wish I didn't put this paper off to the last minute. Let's see what everyone else is up to. I really gotta do some research. See if anyone on Facebook knows about it. You were like my lover and my best friend, all wrapped in one with a ribbon on it and all.
Okay, I am 92% addicted to social media. Yeah, I think it's time to go get some help for this. Let's see where it can go. Steps for rehabilitation. Yeah, for some of these with go outside, limit your memberships, definitely things I could start implementing in my life to help out. They tried to make me go to rehab. I said no, no, no. Yes, I've been black. So I totally got an F on this paper. And the night I was trying to write it, I was on Facebook and Twitter and just so distracted. Couldn't focus on the paper. And now obviously I see it's affecting me, affecting my grades. And, you know, school's important to me. So maybe if it's affecting it, maybe I do need to go try to get some help. Something out about this social media thing that I keep getting into.
Hey.
How are you doing today?
Well,
I've been better.
And what do you care to talk about?
Well, you know, for the longest time, my friends keep telling me that I'm addicted to social media. I'm on my phone all the time. I'm always on Facebook and Twitter, and like an excessive amount. And I didn't think that I was. I just thought, oh, they're whatever. They just don't have as good a social life as me. And I don't know. I just realized today that when I got a paper back and I saw it had an F, and I was just thinking that night that I was writing the paper, I was on Facebook and I was on Twitter and I was not focusing on the paper. You know, I was seeing what Polly D was up to and just didn't focus on the paper at all. And I saw, you know, obviously now it's affecting me and I don't want to fail out of school. And so I think maybe I do need some help. Maybe my friends are right. I don't know. I didn't think I had a media addiction, but, you know, it seemed like I've been on Facebook twice since I just started talking to you. So I don't know.
Well, why don't we start with putting your phone down, you can put it over there, and we'll see if you can go this entire session without checking your phone for any type of media or anything like that. Sound okay? Think that'll be tough?
But I forgot to check in, though.
So check in on where? Facebook?
Foursquare.
So you're addicted not only on Facebook, and you are also on Foursquare. Where else are you addicted?
Foursquare, Twitter, Facebook. You know, I'm always checking CNN, everything, you know, all those cool apps. So,
well, do you know what the definition of an internet addiction is?
I don't know. Someone who's on it all the time.
Well, let's see if this applies to you. Internet addiction is the capacity of the internet for socialization, and it is a primary reason for the excessive amount of time people spend having real-time interactions using email, discussion forums, chat rooms, and online games. Do you think that describes you?
Well, I mean, maybe. I don't know. I'm playing games all the time. I'm always on it, but...
Are you on it before you go to bed and when you get up in the morning?
Oh, yeah.
And what about during class?
These classes can get so boring, you know, and so, yeah, I'll get on it during class, just kind of, you know, tweet how boring class is.
Okay, you're definitely addicted to social media. But I'm going to help you get through this. And I'm going to have you do a 5-day step plan, which will consist of the first day. You will write on all of your social media websites that, you know, you post a status that you will not be on it for 2 weeks. Okay? That will be day one. Day two, you will not check into Facebook at all. You can still maybe check into your other accounts, but just not using Facebook. Day three, you will not check into anything else. No Twitter, no Foursquare, nothing, okay? Day four, you will stop using your phone as an alarm clock, because this will prevent the urge for you to actually, you know, want to check in and check all that stuff. And then also on day five, you will stop texting completely. You'll do this for 2 weeks. And that should, you know, hopefully give you a step in the right direction of getting over your addiction.
All right, you think that'll help?
I think it will. Do you think you can handle this?
Yeah, I suppose. I guess I'll try anything.
Okay, well, we'll do this for 2 weeks, and then if you need any help in between then, I'll be here, and, you know, we'll see where you're at in 2 weeks.
All right. Thanks, Doc.
So, Chris, what brings you into my office today?
Just lately, my social media addiction has really been taking a grasp and a serious chokehold on my life. Just recently, my girlfriend of a year and like 6 months just stormed out on me, and we just had the worst fight in our relationship. And that was basically my wake-up call that this is really affecting my life. And so I just spoke with one of my really good friends, Kevin, and I just thought, today is the day I need to get help and go speak to someone about my addiction.
Okay. And how often do you think you use social media? How many times do you check Facebook or check in places, text message?
I can tell you every night before I go to bed, I at least check my Facebook. In the morning, like by the time before I get out of bed or at least before I do anything productive, I would have at least checked my Facebook. I would say when I'm in my car driving, I'm usually at texting, and then I'm also, a bad habit of mine is also usually just checking my Twitter, or again, just checking my live updates. And so, yeah, even when I should be focusing on productive things, I find myself distracted. And so, yeah, constantly throughout the day, I'll definitely say I find myself on social media.
Okay, well, to inform you about how serious internet addiction is, I'm going to read you something that I found in an article recently. And it discusses how a woman actually had been divorced by her husband because of her excessive use of the internet. And it says, the woman did not come to her senses and continued to use the internet so much that she forgot to buy food for her children, to take them to doctor appointments, and to buy enough oil to warm her home. So, you know, you're not alone. At least, you know, you haven't gone to any big extremes.
Yeah.
What I'm going to have you do is I want you to quit using any social media. You're going to stop cold turkey for at least a couple of weeks. You are strong enough to handle it. You'll be fine, you know.
Like right now?
Like right now.
Oh.
Right now for 2 weeks, and I'll have you come back in, and we'll talk about it. And, you know, if you are feeling stressed out in between those 2 weeks, you could certainly come back in and talk to me about it. But you're strong enough to handle this, and I think you can get through it, so.
All right. Yeah, I'll definitely take your advice. And you are right. I do need to start right now.
So, I've been on this media fast for about a week now, and it's been tough. I haven't used my phone. Usually when I'm doing homework, I have my computer sitting right here, my phone right here, I'll have my iPod on, but as you can see, none of that right now, and it's actually going really well. I just had, you know, got a B+ on another paper that I wrote, and, you know, I'm actually being able to absorb the notes that I'm taking right now, and my assignments are going great. It's a lot of hard work, but I know it's for my own good, and the results are showing with that B+ paper that I got. And so, a few times I've wanted to go check my phone and text and everything, but been able not to. So I think I can make it. I think it's going very well so far.
No, I'm so glad we had that talk. Yeah, I'm glad I made a big change in my life. No, I don't want to lose you again, so I really appreciate you being here. So it's been a couple weeks since I went and met with the therapist, and I am just a total happier person all around now. All my relationships have improved for the better, my friends and my family, and especially my girlfriend. I now take the time out of my day to just go see her in person, because just personal text messages just weren't the same. And yeah, I definitely took the therapist's advice to just quit cold turkey. And I'll say I did have some struggles at first, but then once I just kind of put mind over matter, things got better each day slowly. And yeah, I can just say overall, I'm just a lot happier person, and I appreciate all the help from the doctor.
Bad. I haven't seen you in a while.
Dude, I've been outside my house. I'm no longer stuck on my social media.
Yeah, same here, actually, you know.
Did you see the therapist I recommended?
Yeah, I did. Did you?
Yeah, I definitely did. And she convinced me to stop this cold turkey right there.
Yeah, she put me on like this 5-day program. And
wow.
Just to kind of go off, you know, and it's helped. Man, I haven't even been on Facebook all day today. Days seem brighter, not today, obviously, but other days. And yeah, that therapist is a miracle worker, huh?
That's awesome, man. I'm glad to hear that.
Yeah, it was great. So, you know, I feel good about life moving on.
Yeah.
How are things with you and your girl?
Things are going really well.
Really?
Our relationship has never been stronger. Like,
really?
I mean, my grades have improved. That's also really good.
Yeah, dude, I feel like my GPA is boosting up right
there
now.
There you go.
I've been able to study a lot better. You know, it's a lot easier to study when I don't have Facebook and everything up. So.
Yeah, no, I got you, definitely.
Hey, yeah, thanks for trying to convince me to.
I'm glad. It really worked out for you.
Glad to hear things are going great.
Yeah.
Better get to class, man. Yeah. I gotta turn another paper. See you later.
All right, man, we'll catch you later, all right?
Yeah.
All right, we'll see you. Similar to giving birth to 160 kids and breaking up to 3,200 bones at a time.